This is important. If a child takes this and doesn't get sick for a year, can you imagine if you give it to 100 children, out of whom 10 would otherwise die? So I believe it's important. We have to sell this directly to people. Because if you go through all the scientific procedures, it will take 15 or 20 years and everyone will be dead. We can't afford that. So what we have to do is cut the chain. We've proven that the product isn't dangerous, it can't kill, so we have to act fast and give it to the children. Now people are asking to buy it for their homes, saying that since they've been using it, they haven't had malaria. So what am I supposed to do? Fold my arms and sit around and wait?
The plasmodium, which is the parasite that causes malaria, is transmitted to human blood by the mosquito. If you have a way of preventing the plasmodium from settling in the blood, then you pretty much have a way of stopping the development of malaria. The evidence we have that it works is that we conducted a medically supervised trial in the neighborhood of Pekin, and the result was that during the entire year there was no malaria. That was a very valuable experiment in terms of using neem in Senegal.
You want to try to cut the profits of the multinationals? How many companies are there already in the US or France making malaria drugs? And how much money are they bringing in? It's up to us to take responsibility.
South of Dakar, the town of Kaolack is locally known as the mosquito capital of the world. Sheikh Bamba was inspired to begin his own neem research after watching a TV documentary on its uses in India. After experimenting on himself and his family, he started bottling his own neem oil medicine and giving free samples to the local health centers.
People are finding that the malaria medicines that they buy from the chemist don't work. You take them and you don't recover. But with neem, automatically the malaria is under control.
Although some people locally have started buying his medicine, Sheikh Bamba does not aim to make a profit from it. But all his research gave him another idea, to use the neem oil he extracted to make his own brand of soaps and skin creams, which have become popular around town and allowed him and his family to build a small but thriving business, which in turn allows him to keep the price of the medicine to a minimum.
It is not much, but we've tried to do what we can. With an oil press, pestle and mortar, and some basic kitchen equipment, with that, we started extracting neem oil, little by little.
On the outskirts of Dakar, we found a small business beginning to invest in its own neem research, funded from sales of organic fertilizers, insect repellents and cleaning products. All made from neem.
We at Senchim couldn't just fold our arms and sit around doing nothing, waiting for mana to fall from the sky. The solution we chose is to do what we can with our own money and manufacture marketable products that can provide us with our own resources and develop our independent research.
We have the natural resource, we have the people with the intellectual skills and technical training, and we have the people who can manufacture products to international standards. The obstacles we face are part of a much bigger global issue, and if you don't understand that, nothing will make sense. That's why we say that we are neem militants.
The Mahatma ate chapatis, boiled beets, some raw vegetables and oranges. On the side of his plate was a large lump of very bitter neem leaves, a notable blood cleanser. With a spoon, he separated a portion and placed it on my dish. I bolted it down with water, remembering my childhood days when mother had forced me to swallow the unpleasant dose. Gandhi, however, was eating the neem paste bit by bit, without a distaste. In this trifling incident, I noted the Mahatma's ability to detach his mind from the senses at will.
Dr. Raghunatha Rao at the Institute of Nutrition in Hyderabad wants neem to be used everywhere that mosquitoes breed, such as overhead water tanks and the standing water of rice paddy fields.
When the mosquitoes lay their eggs on the surface of the water, they come into contact with the neem concentration that is present in the water medium. when they come into the contact, the neem principles act as a growth retardants, and they will not allow the mosquito larvae to grow into full grown adult. So before they attain the adult stage, they will die. Unless and until they reach the adult stage, they cannot go to the human beings, they cannot go to the pigs to suck the blood.
In terms of what we've just talked about, neem inhibiting mosquito and larvae growth,
yeah,
what would you say are its advantages over alternative methods for doing the same thing?
If you promote pesticides for the control of mosquito population, particularly in rice fields, you need to dump tons of pesticides in the environment. It damages the environment. So nobody has got right to damage the environment. We have to protect the environment. So neem plays a major role.
At the moment, neem pesticides only account for 0.2% of the total global pesticide industry, which is worth £17 billion a year.
Over the past decade, neem has become the subject of a controversy. It's all about if anyone should profit from the tree and its unique properties. Companies have the right to take out patents on neem. That amounts to them stealing the knowledge of indigenous people. The environmentalist Dr. Vandana Shiva campaigns on this issue.
My consciousness about the neem really started when I started to look at the high cost of industrial agriculture. And I started to look at farming and found out how dependent agriculture had been made on chemicals that were created for war. Then we had Bhopal, 1984, 2nd December night. Killed 3,000 people in one night, one pesticide plant's leak. My first response was, why do we have to have such genocide when we have trees like the neem? So I collected saplings and went to Bhopal when we had a very big convergence of all concerned citizens of India. Started a campaign called No More Bhopals, Plant a Neem.
In 1995, Dr. Shiva discovered that an American agrochemical company, W.R. Grace, had taken out a patent on the fungicidal use of neem. She decided to challenge their right to do this at the European Patent Office. This landmark case was to last for 10 years, and eventually Dr. Shiva's team won.
We wanted to reveal what biopiracy is, this patenting of traditional knowledge and indigenous biodiversity. We thought a patent that's held by the biggest superpower of the world and one of the biggest chemical giants of the world would be an effective patent to take on. The claim they were making in it was basically inventing the use of neem products to control fungal diseases, inventing the way to make an extract, inventing the percentages of extract, and we were able to establish what was being claimed by Grace and the U.S. Department of Agriculture as a novel inventive step. This is everyday use.
This is the place where a lot of India's patenting laws end up being argued over and sometimes defeated. It's the Supreme Court here in New Delhi. Lawyer Prashant Bhushan has fought in many such cases.
Do you think it can ever be justified to have patents on any application whatsoever of biological life forms?
No, in fact, I feel that there is no justification to have patents at all, and certainly not for life forms.
What's wrong with patents?
Well, I feel that giving a monopoly right to a person just because he got there first is not morally justified. It's not even justified in terms of expedience, because justification which is normally given for this is that it will encourage research and development, and private companies will put in more money if they can profit from it. But in fact, most of the basic research that has been done in the world so far on anything has been done in publicly funded institutions. And therefore, I see no reason why private monopoly rights for profit should be created on the basis of intellectual property. I feel that we are creating a society based on greed when we allow and we encourage these kind of intellectual property rights.